Hello students, in the last video we discussed about some important things in association with YDSA setter, like very last number of bright fringes that we get on the screen. So going ahead, today, in this video we shall discuss few more important things from the point of competitive exam in connection with interference pattern. So let's go ahead. So the situation is like this. I have YDSA setter screen is here. On the screen, this is a point O. I have a light coming from source S1. I have a light coming from source S2. And both these waves, coming from S1 as well as coming from S2, they will travel path of equal length. So path difference I have got here S2P minus S1P equal to 0. So then naturally S2O, S1O equal to 0. So I2O I have got central bright band, reference band. Now what I would like to do is that, what I would like to know that in one of path, say in this path, if I introduce a thin transparent sheet of thickness T, what is T? Thickness of sheet. And the material which I am using for this is mu. Refractive index is mu. Now the curiosity is, what is to happen with pattern? Now because of introducing this sheet, remember that wave from slit S1 no longer will have only to travel S1O distance. Part of the distance it has to travel into the air and part of the distance it has to travel into the optical media. So the total distance traveled by this wave now from S1, I will have S1O minus T, this is in the air, plus it travels a distance into that optical media also. And whenever I have to add such a journey in the air, I should make use of the concept called equivalent path. What is that equivalent path? It is that distance traveled by the light in air in the interval of time, whatever it takes to travel certain distance in the optical media. And such a distance we call equivalent path to this path into the optical media. And that we can work out, optical path or equivalent path, how much we get? We get optical path equal to mu T, I can say. New refractive index T is the thickness of that journey, you can say. So I have got now equivalent path to be added here. This is mu T. What I got this? Path to be travelled by the light from source S1. S1 O dash I say now. Before introducing this, it was a S1 O only. Now S1 O dash I have written. And again, remember that. If I would like to get central bright band only, to get a central bright band, path difference should be zero. So path difference should be zero, any these two paths have to be equal. That's what I would write. I would like to write. So I write here S1O dash should be equal to S2O. If this is happening at the place where this is happening, I am going to get again central bright band. This I have got S1O minus T plus mu T equal to S2O. I'll rearrange this. S2O minus S1O equal to what I have got is mu minus 1 into T, and I am going to focus over here. Look here, mu refractive index greater than 1. If mu is greater than 1, this is positive, right hand is positive. Right hand is positive, what does it suggest then? Length of the path traveled from second source to reach O is to be greater than length of the path traveled by the light from S1 source. So I simply mean that S2O is to be greater than S1O. And when will that happen? If this O, I mean central bright band, shift in the upward direction, say it has come to this O dash. Now this is the path traveled by light from S2. This is a path traveled by the light from S1. So as if that has happened. So got my point? Because of introducing a transparent sheet, what has happened is that now this second path has as if become longer. So you mean the point O has got shifted to the O dash. So that's the conclusion we would like to arrive at. So when you introduce a transparent sheet in the path of one of the wave, the central bright band which was at O has got shifted upward. Now the question is, instead of introducing sheet in the upper path, if sheet is introduced in the lower path, what would happen? When you do that, when you work out that, in that case you will find S1O greater than S2O, which simply means that this O has got shifted in a downward direction. And that's the clue I get for to understand shift is in what direction. So simple to conclude, if transparent sheet is introduced in the path of upper wave, I say upper and lower with respect to that I thought, like lower, upper. If transparent sheet is introduced in the upper part, shift is upward. If transparent sheet is introduced in the lower part, shift is downward. And again, by referring to the geometry, one can derive the shift that we have got in the fringes. And that is given by the expression shift equal to mu minus 1 into T d divided by d. So the shift in the pattern or shift in the fringes is given by this relation. That can also be written in another form. See, I can multiply and divide by lambda. If I do so, lambda d by d I'll get n by lambda also. So which makes me to write S equal to mu minus 1 T beta divided by lambda. So the important equation I have arrived at or I have written. So the concept to consolidate, whenever a transparent sheet is introduced in one of the path, in a YDS setup, the whole pattern gets shifted. And the direction of shift is decided by where the sheet is introduced. Sheet introduced in the upper path, upper shift. Sheet introduced in the lower path, lower shift. But then obviously the question which you may have in your mind, what if it is introduced in both the path? Again that I have to see that. For which path this mu value and t value will decide. Whichever path becomes longer, optically longer, it is not cubic. I have to see this one. Say both the sheets are of same thickness, but medias are different. Then whichever sheet has got more mu, it will have shift in the opposite direction. See, this lower path has got more mu, it will have shift in the upward direction. If lower upper path has got more mu, it will have shift in the lower direction, opposite direction. So, if thickness is same, mu is different, I can decide. If mu is same, thickness is different, again same. Say both of them are glass. Upper sheet is of bigger, I mean more thickness than the lower one. More thickness here, shift is downward. More thickness here, shift is upward. So this is how we can consolidate about shift in the interference pattern because of introducing a sheet. So this derivation and all, we need not to go in much detail about that to be remembered conceptually and this equation to be remembered. Now going ahead, next thing that I would like to highlight and understand, I am interested to know some basics about intensity of interference pattern. If you remember, in the beginning itself, we had an equation for intensity. I need to remind you that first. What was that expression? You remember? IR, I write. In fact, I had this equal to R square. Am I right? R square equal to A square plus B square plus 2AB cos pi. Amplitude of the first wave, amplitude of the second wave, phase difference between two superposing waves. So, our equation, general equation for intensity. Now, I am also interested about maximum and minimum intensity. Generally, the competitive examination, they ask the ratio of I max to I minimum. So let me make the things available directly which I can take and attempt the questions in competitive exam. So I write I maximum. You know, when do I get I maximum? On the basis of this cos value. On the basis of phase difference. For phase difference being even integral multiple of pi, that is 0, 2 pi. You get this cos pi as a 1 and you have an expression a plus b whole square. I write a square plus b square 2ab. I have got this as 1 expansion of this bracket. Now this can also be written in this fashion. I max equal to, I can write, you know, intensity of the light is directly to the square of amplitude. So amplitude I have got. So then this can be written as root of I1 plus root of I2 whole square. So this is the equation that I will be using whenever I am in need of maximum intensity in the interference pattern. Straight away I can refer to this equation. Similarly, minimum intensity I can get. When will I have minimum intensity? Depending upon this phase difference or integral multiple of pi, pi, 3 pi, so on, this value is a minus 1, a square plus b square minus 2ab, and this I give a minus b whole square. Same in term of intensity I can write, I minimum equal to root of I1 minus root of I2 whole square. Again, this I have got important equation for competitive exam. So when if they ask me to work out straight away I max to I minimum, a plus b whole square divided by a minus b whole square, or I max to I minimum root of I1 plus root of I2 whole square by root of I1 minus root of I2 whole square. So by making use of this, I can work out very easily. Now the next one more thing which I would like to keep ready for the competitive exam about intensity. I may have a situation where the two superposing waves are of same intensity. So what my point? If the superposing waves are of same intensity, I1 equal to I2 equal to, let it as I0. In that case, this equation I would like to write in a comfortable form which can be recalled very easily for competitive exams. So I write this IR equal to, see what I am going to do here, I1 plus I2 plus 2 root I1 I2 cos phi I am going to write. And again with modification, certain steps I can go ahead and I get the equation 4I0 cos square phi by 2. Again important equation. When do I use this equation? Whenever I have to find resultant intensity in the interference pattern, in case if the superposing waves are of equal intensity, in that case I can use this equation. So by making use of this equation, say maximum intensity I would like to understand, phi 0, phase difference 0, this comes 1, and I how much maximum resultant intensity, 4I0. So generally with the two sources, incoherent sources, one of intensity I1, another of intensity I2, if you ask me how much is maximum, I would say I1 plus I2. But in interference, something hatke it is, with coherent sources particularly. What is that hatke? Instead of getting this as I0 plus I0 as a 2I0, I am getting 4I0. Same way, at minimum, I am getting 0. Important equation. And one more point that I would like to highlight, two superposing waves I had. In a YDSE, I had only two slits. With that, my resultant intensity I got 4I0 cos square phi by 2. Now I may have a question, what if the YDSE has got multiple slits? Instead of two slits, if I have multiple slits, 3 slits, 4 slits, n slits, then again all those amplitudes I need to take into account, amplitude of the light from all those slits. I will use the basics of vector algebra. I will get this resultant, and I will get a resultant intensity given by the expression IR equal to n square I0 cos square phi by 2. Interesting to see here. If two sources I had, two waves I had, I got this as a 2 square. If three slits, three sources, three waves are there, I'll get this as a 9 I0 and a 3 square. Four slits, four sources, four waves, I'll get this as a 16 I0. If I have n slits, n sources, coherent sources, n waves, I would like to write this equation. Now we are dealing with interference pattern based on value of intensity, maximum and minimum intensity. We happen to talk about visibility of the pattern, contrast of the pattern, visibility of the pattern we say. And in interference pattern, we will have a good visibility. We will have a good visibility if intensity at maximum is maximum. Yani, wherever the bright bands I have got, maximum intensity I should have. Aste alla, it's not only that. Intensity at minimum should be minimum. मैंने at minimum I should have zero intensity. At the places where destructive interference is taking place, I should have made zero intensity. And by taking all these parameters into account, we talk about visibility of interference pattern. And there were the questions. There will be the questions in the NEET examination, competitive examination, where they may ask you to calculate fringe visibility, interference pattern visibility. And visibility of interference pattern is given by the expression I max minus I minimum divided by I max plus I minimum. To start with, this is the equation, but I would like to go ahead some steps so that I can arrive at comfortable formulas to deal in the competitive exam. And what to substitute for I max and I minimum. So I should write this as A plus B whole square, A minus B whole square, A plus B whole square, A minus B whole square. Values I have substituted. So you can expand this A square plus B square plus 2AB. You can expand this A square plus B square minus 2AB. This is a minus here. So a square, b square, b square will get cancelled. And what you get is 4ab. You can expand that. Similarly, in the denominator, a square plus b square plus 2ab. A square plus b square minus 2ab. 2ab, 2ab get cancelled here. And this you get 2a square plus b square. So one can cancel here. And visibility equal to, you can write 2AB divided by A square plus B square. This is in term of amplitude. I can write in term of intensities of superposing waves. So that can be written 2 root I1 I2 whole divided by I1 plus I2. So this is the important expression you can remember for fringe visibility. So these are few of the important things that we have discussed in the present video. So in the next video, we shall discuss about some basics in connection with interference and thin film. So till then, bye-bye.